Thank you, Sejal. A very good morning to one and all present here. I am Lovepreet Singh of Plus 2 Commerce. And today I am here to speak on our amazing past, glorious present, and emerging future. In 3,000 years of our history, people from all over the world have come and invaded us, captured our lands and conquered our minds. From Alexander onwards, the Mughals, the Greek, the Turks, the Britishers, the French, the Dutch, the Portuguese, they all have come and invaded us. But we have not done this to anyone. We have not done this to any nation. Why? It's because we, the Indians, respect the freedom of others. In past 10,000 years of our history, we have not invaded any other nation. And there are some people who go on to say that India has grown intolerant. Secularism is in danger in India. Our port authorities would not detain you just because you are named Khan or anything Muslim. Many famed Indian personalities have faced abuses from the so-called developed countries of the so-called developed world just because of their religion. Friends, the percentages of minorities of many European countries are comparable to that of India. But tell me, the minorities of how many countries can become their national icons? Are there equivalents of APJ Abdul Kalam, A.R. Rahman, Amir Khan, Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan, and so on? Although more than 75% of population of India is Hindu, but as a minority, a person can climb up to any position. He can become an army general, president, prime minister, and so on. The Christian population in India is less than the aggregate of Hindu and Sikh population in United Kingdom, despite the fact Christianity, that is Christmas, the main festival of Christianity. The day of Christmas is a national holiday in India, but Diwali is not a holiday in United Kingdom. In India, we don't take anti-Islam rallies every time a terror attack happens, because we believe terrorism has no religion. And not just now, India has forever been a home for the persecuted communities around the world, like Tibetan Buddhist, early Christianity, and so on. I still remember what respected Kulwant sir said on the day of Gurpurab celebration, that this is the land of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji. I totally agree to it. This is the great land of great Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji, and we believe in humanism. We are connected through our diversities. Do you know what we believe in? We believe in Vasudeva Kutumbakam, which means the whole world is a family. We believe in Atithi Devo Bhava, which means the guest is equivalent to God. And it is our culture which teaches us to respect our nature, our environment, and our nation. We often say Mother Earth, Dharti Ma. We often say Bharat Ma or Bharat Mata, which means Mother India. It's a fact that there is no intolerance in India, but I believe we should be intolerant. Yes, friends, we should be intolerant. We should be intolerant towards the anti-social elements of our society. We should be intolerant towards terrorism. We should be intolerant towards those entities because of which the women are not safe even inside their homes. We should be intolerant towards every stone that is hit towards our soldiers. And we should be intolerant towards every slogan that is raised against our motherland. Friends, the youth has a great role to play in the development of any nation. I believe our history and culture is really glorious. We all need to get inspired from it. And we, the youth, can really contribute a lot. And every action of ours determines the destiny of our nation. And the secret of change is not to focus all our energy on destroying the old, but to focus all our energy on building the new. Let's destroy the negativities through our positivities. Surya, Sun, जब अंधेरा अपनी चरम सीमा पर होता है, जब अंधकार को लगता है कि उसकी विजय है, उसने विजय प्राप्त कर ली है, तब सूर्य निकलता है और सूर्य की मात्र एक किरण से अंधकार का वध हो जाता है, अंधेरा छट जाता है. फ्लावर, पुष्प, जलज, कमल का फूल कहां खिलता है? कीचड़ में खिलता है. सो वी ऑल नीड टू गेट इंस्पायर्ड फ्रॉम दीज थिंग्स विच आर इन अ नेचर. We observe these things. So, at the end, I would like to relate some words of the great APJ Abdul Kalam ji. He said, ask what we can do and do what has to be done to make India what America and other Western countries are today. So, I am relating those words. I am saying, ask what we can do and do what has to be done to make India the India of our dreams, to make India the leader of this world. Thank you.